So after the storm was over and you left your shelter, what did you see?
I left where I was, and it was just, you know, pouring rain, and I saw some power lines down where I was. And then I started driving to Joplin to look for my boyfriend, who's now my husband. And he lived right in the middle of Joplin.
Wow.
So I left to go find him because he wasn't responding to my text messages. And I assumed that he was, you know, the sub towers were down or something.
Mm-hmm.
But once I got to about 7th Street in Joplin, everything started to become shut down, and started to see trees down, and then I got up to the top of a hill, and when I looked down over that hill, all I saw was everything flattened.
Wow. So how were you feeling at that moment? Were you just in awe? Were you scared?
I was terrified. I shouldn't have been able to see where my boyfriend lived,
but
I could because everything was flat, and I just knew right then and there that his apartment was gone.
Wow.
And I had no idea if I was going to find him there, or if he was hurt, or if he was dead, and I had never seen anything like that. I had been amazed by just the giant trees that I had seen down my way to this area of Joplin, and I thought that was the craziest thing I'd ever seen. And then once I got to the top of that hill and saw, I was in complete disbelief.
Wow. So did you see first responders right away, or did you see just people lingering around trying to find family members and friends?
There were first responders. It took me from where I lived to where he lived, should have taken me about 10 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
It took me about an hour and a half, almost 2 hours, to get to a place where I could park my car and then walk another probably half mile.
Wow.
Where he lived. And they had first responders shutting down roads. There was police officers. There were, I think there were maybe some kind of National Guard and firefighters already on scene. And attempting to direct traffic, shutting down roads. I saw a lot of people trying to help, and then I saw a lot of people wandering around looking for people that they couldn't find, and also people digging and trying to get people out of houses. Now, I was really focused on trying to find my boyfriend. And so I kept my mind to that as I was walking. And you had to be really careful. Like I said, I walked about half a mile. And you had to be really, really careful where you were walking because there was debris everywhere. And there were power lines down, and they were live. And I actually had somebody yell at me because I started to walk. I wasn't paying good enough attention. I started to walk right in front of a live wire that was in the road.
Wow.
And, so it was really... I wasn't united with him until 1:30 in the morning.
Wow.
At a hospital in Miami, Oklahoma.
Wow. So you had no idea if he was okay until that point.
I got to his apartment, and his entire apartment was gone. His car was completely destroyed, and there was no sign of him anywhere.
Wow.
So I got back to my car, and I drove to where I work because none of the cell phones were working, and I thought that maybe the landlines would still work, so I drove to where I work to use some landlines, called my parents back in Michigan to help me get some phone numbers because the internet wasn't working. And I called around to different places in Joplin that were taking the wounded, and he wasn't at any of those places. I tried to call the news station that he works for. People weren't picking up, but finally somebody at that news station picked up. And he just happened to be, when the tornado hit, he happened to be in the same complex as the sports reporter.
Okay.
And the sports reporter was with him and found him, and he was injured, and helped him get to the hospital. And the sports reporter had made contact with the station, and so they were able to tell me that he was in the hospital. That was about 9:30 at night.
Mm-hmm.
But at that point, I knew he was alive, at least.
That's good, yeah.
But, I knew he was in the hospital. But there was no way to get to the hospital. I wanted to, and I was trying to, but there was really no way to get there. And so I just had to go home and try to calm down and wait for the phone lines to, for the cell phone lines to start working again and get in contact. And he was able to contact his parents who live in Chicago. And because obviously he couldn't get in touch with me, the cell phones weren't working.
Mm-hmm.
And they... and let them know that he was being transferred to a hospital in Oklahoma. And around 11 o'clock at night, 11:30 maybe, 7:30, my cell phone just randomly started to work again, and I had a million voicemails and text messages, and one was from his mom, who was calling to let me know that he had been moved to Oklahoma. And I got in the car and drove to Miami, even though the highway was closed. I didn't have any idea how to get there. I just started driving, and God really led me there. I don't have any explanation as to how I knew how to get there except for that. And I finally got into the town of Miami and thought, well, I made it here, but I don't have any idea where the hospital is. And as soon as I had that thought, an ambulance pulled out in front of me and led me right to the emergency room.
Wow.
So that was kind of a miracle of the evening, and once I got there, it was about 1 in the morning, and he was in the ER, and they were stitching him up. He had been in his bathtub in his second-story apartment and had actually flown around in the tornado. It had picked him up and then dropped him in the parking lot of his apartment complex, which the way he landed, it shattered his hip.
Mm-hmm.
And so he had to have surgery right away to put a metal rod and metal plate in his hip. And then he had lacerations and needed stitches all over his body. And he spent the next about two months recovering, and another probably month and a half or two months after that on crutches. And is still recovering from the injuries that he received. But now, 2 years later, almost completely back to normal.
Wow, that's good. So how are you guys doing emotionally after that?
It's hard. It's hard when the weather gets bad again.
Mm-hmm.
Because you don't... until you've really experienced what a tornado can actually do or seen what it can do, you might not take it so seriously. And now we have really, really seen what it can do, and we've been really lucky that, you know, he was alive. Or he, you know, God kept him alive, and God kept me safe. Mm-hmm. But when the weather gets bad, you can't help but start to get really anxious.
Mm-hmm.
To go through that again. And
right.
Lose everything and have to start over again, and mm-hmm. and you never know. We definitely get anxious, and we definitely take the weather very seriously around here. And so when they say something's going to be bad, we're watching it all day.
Mm-hmm.
And we have a new apartment. We're on the first floor this time, and we also have a storm shelter that we can go to. So we've been using the storm shelters anytime we get a tornado warning, and that has brought a lot of peace of mind to us, just having a storm shelter. Yeah, it makes me sick to my stomach, honestly. The pictures look just like Joplin, and some people say that we were lucky that this the tornado hit us on a Sunday because kids weren't in school, and you know, a lot of people that would work in the city, you know, weren't there because it was a Sunday, and for it to hit them on a Monday with kids in school and so many probably, you know, more people in town, I can't imagine it, and I can't, the school and the kids, that just kills me.
Mm-hmm.
But the images look exactly like Joplin, and I just know exactly what they're going through, and you just feel terrible because you can't imagine going through that again, and for someone else to have to go through it, it's just as bad.
So.
And, I can't even put into words, I think, how I feel, but it definitely brings some anxiety, and it's so incredibly sad and almost sickening, because you just don't want something that you've already seen, and something that's already happened to you and affected you, and 2 years later, we're still recovering. You know, we're not there yet. And to see it start fresh somewhere else, you just can't even...
Mm-hmm.
It's hard to even imagine and just say, wow, I know what you're going to be going through for the next few years.
In Joplin?
So that Joplin sent a crew of people last night.
Okay.
I believe they were police officers and firefighters to go there. I'm sure that there's more being set up by the city to send people. I don't.